that this opening riff uses just the E major chord and the A major chord, but in a way that I'm pretty certain you've never tried before, unless you've had a go at this riff before. We do is play a standard E major chord, but 12 frets up. So if we play an E major chord, we're at fret 1 and 2, and we just slide all of that up 12 frets. Imagine the double dot here is the open strings, and that's our E major chord, still the E major chord, but played 12 frets up. I'm on the middle pickup of a T-style guitar, and I'm going through my Plexi-style Victory Sheriff 22, which I'm pretty certain Graham Coxon has even got himself, though it's just an alternative to a good old Marshall Plexi amp. Now, I'm pretty certain we don't actually have this thickest string ringing out at all, so I'm going to stick my thumb just here to kind of mute it a little bit. But if we get overtones of that, or if you have it ringing out, it still sounds pretty cool. It's just an E after all. After then, there's a couple of options, really. What we need is like an A major chord, and then the A sus 2. So there's different ways of doing that. I think Graham Coxon just kind of flattens off his fingers a little bit like this, and then goes on the tip. But, you know, there are a few different ways to get the same effect. But I'm pretty sure we go for this. So just with that thumb really static and just muting that E string as best we can, I've seen other people teach this kind of more like this, you know, moving the two fingers from here to here. I think we need to flatten off those fingers just to get that A chord sound. But there's certainly no barring kind of happen. I've seen this kind of thing happening on other tutorials and in tabs, and I don't think it's that. I think it's just this kind of E and A chord shape. Strumming wise, it's down, mute, up, down, mute, up, down. Then we change to the A chord. Up, down, down. One strum of that A sus 2. That's as close as I can get anyway. I look forward to hearing some of how you guys get on in the comments below. The chorus is this really cool little cheeky Blur style riff. So we're walking up an arpeggio here and a little hammer-on flick off. It's kind of unclear whether it... I've seen it tabbed as the open to second. I think that's kind of totally valid. It's just not what I believe he plays. It's kind of... He sometimes goes to the major, sometimes the minor, because he's just kind of throwing it all in there. Harmonically, it's an E major chord. After that little riff, it's a first fret power chord to a second fret power chord, so B flat to B. The second time it happens, it goes from the C to the B. And then we have a chord progression. G to D over the F sharp, E minor, D, then C, C over B, but I would play it like this, especially to get the A sus4 to the A major, and then B flat to B again. So that was G, D over F sharp, E minor, D over F sharp again, Purcell choice, C add 9, G over B, so this is a G chord without the G in the bass. Your third finger's already there for the A sus4. And then first fret power chord, second fret power chord. And the bit that always flummoxed me when I was learning this riff as a teenager, it's a B7 arpeggio. And then I'd stick the little finger down at the 8th fret, string 2, string 3. So that's the 7th fret, 6th fret, 7th fret, 8, 8 with the little finger or the 3rd finger. Then we have the easiest guitar solo known to man. At least, again, that's what I believe he plays. It's always hard to work out Graham Coxon and stuff, really. He's always doing something that's a little bit different, a little bit unique. It's what makes him so good. But this is the 14th fret in the middle two strings. To 13 and 14, so like an E sus 4 to an E, then a little blues based. So yeah, quite easy, but still, I'm not 100% sure that's what he does. That's just to the best of my understanding. Thank you so much for checking out this tutorial. I'll leave a couple of other cool blur tutorials on the screen for you now to check out. Let me know what you thought of this in the comments below, and I hope to see you next time on this Andy Guitar YouTube channel, website, and indeed on the Andy Guitar app.